Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre and this is audio number 110 for you. In previous audio, at the end we were discussing algebra of vectors. So whenever you talk about algebra, it means you are talking about addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. Addition of vectors is done, as I told in the previous audio, in two ways. One is triangle law of addition, another is parallelogram law of addition. In 1 minute, I will revise what is triangle law of addition. So suppose you have two vectors, A bar and B bar, which you want to add. What you do is draw A bar. At the terminal point of A bar, draw the vector B bar using the concept of parallel or equal vectors. So at the end of A bar, draw the vector B bar. So end point, terminal point of A bar will be initial point of B bar. Right, now what you do is draw a vector which starts at initial point of A bar and ends at terminal point of B bar. Then it is this vector is a addition of A bar and B bar, and as the triangle is formed, it is triangle law of addition. Second thing that we saw was parallelogram law of addition. The word itself suggests that we are going to form a parallelogram. How it will be formed? Suppose you have two vectors, A bar and B bar. You make them co-initial by using the concept of equality of the vectors. So suppose A bar is one vector, B bar is another vector. You make them co-initial. Suppose OA is A bar, OB is B bar. Now you complete the parallelogram, and a vector which begins at O, and or a vector means what we will now say is, as you have completed the parallelogram, there will be two diagonals. A diagonal of that parallelogram which begins at O will be the addition of A bar and B bar. As it is a parallelogram, it is called parallelogram law of addition. Then you have subtraction of the two vectors. Two vectors are to be subtracted. That means I have given two vectors, say A bar and B bar. How I will form A bar minus B bar. See, A bar minus B bar is addition of A bar and minus B bar. What is minus B bar? It is opposite vector of B bar. Right? It is a vector B bar and minus B bar. What is the difference? They are vectors having same magnitude but exactly opposite direction. So, once you are given A bar and B bar, you can draw vector minus B bar and then you add that minus B bar with A bar and minus B bar. When you add them by using any law, either it may be triangle law or it may be parallelogram law that you use, then this addition of the two vectors A bar plus this minus B bar will result in a new vector which will be called as A bar minus B bar. Right? Next thing is, what is scalar multiplication of a vector? So you are given a vector, say A bar, and I want to find what is K into A bar, where K is any scalar. K may be positive or K may be negative. So then K A bar is a vector which is scalar multiple of A bar. Right? Now there are three possibilities for that K. K may be greater than 0, K may be equal to 0, or K may be less than 0. If K is greater than 0, then K A bar is in the same direction as that of A bar. Right? And its magnitude is K times the magnitude of A bar. If K is 0, then K A bar is a 0 vector. And if K is less than 0, then K A bar is in the direction opposite to A bar. Right? And its magnitude will be K times the magnitude of A bar. So, if you take minus A bar, then also it is a scalar multiple of A bar actually. What is minus A bar? It is minus 1 into A bar. So it is a scalar multiple of the vector. For any vector a bar, you should remember certain things. 1 into a bar is same as a bar. Minus 1 into a bar is minus a bar, opposite vector of a bar. 0 into a bar is 0 bar. And k into 0 bar, if you have a 0 vector, and if you multiply it by k, k into 0 bar is 0 bar. Right? So this is very straightforward, very easy to understand, nothing difficult. Now there are certain properties. If a bar and b bar are any two vectors and k and m any two scalars, then k a bar plus m a bar, k a bar is a scalar multiple of a bar, the scalar involved is k, plus m a bar, you can write it as k plus m inside the bracket into a bar. Okay. Then if it is suppose k into bracket a bar plus b bar, now you know how to add two vectors. So k into bracket a bar plus b bar, it will be k a bar plus k b bar. Right, this is called distributive property. K into a bar plus b bar is k a bar plus k b bar. Similarly, we have seen k plus m inside the bracket into a bar, it will be also k a bar plus m a bar. That is also distributive property. And k into m a bar, what is m a bar? It is a scalar multiple of a bar by m. So k into m a bar is km into a bar. Also, you can make the juggling, that means km into a bar can be written also as mk into a bar, or it can be written as m into k a bar. All such things are possible, right? And you can see easily that they are really possible. Okay, now how to calculate, very important, how to calculate unit vector in the direction of a bar. If a bar is any given vector and if I want to calculate unit vector in that direction, what is unit vector? A vector whose magnitude is 1 is a unit vector. Okay, so what you do is you take vector a bar, calculate its magnitude, say mod of a bar, and divide the vector a bar by its magnitude. Then you get a vector whose magnitude is 1, but the direction is same. So it is a unit vector. So a cap will be what? What will be the working formula for a cap? It is a bar upon mod of a bar. Or you can also say a bar upon a, because a conventionally, small a is a magnitude of vector a bar. Small b is magnitude of vector b bar. Like that. So if I want to calculate a cap, what is a cap? Unit vector in the direction of a bar. It will be, the working rule for that will be, you take the vector a bar, divide it by its magnitude, then it becomes a unit vector. So what is to be remembered? A cap is a bar upon a, right? One thing also we can observe, that if a bar and b bar are parallel or collinear vectors, then we can write a bar as m into b bar, where m is non-zero scalar. A bar will be m into b bar, right? Where m is a non-zero scalar, it can be a positive or negative, that doesn't matter. But whenever they are collinear, a bar and b bar, whenever they are collinear, any of those two vectors can be represented as a scalar multiple of other vector. This is very important property, right? So whenever two vectors are collinear, one vector can be expressed as scalar multiple of other vector. Now whether that scalar will be positive or negative, that depends, but it is a non-zero scalar, it cannot be zero. Because if you take a bar is m into b bar, and if m is zero, then a bar is zero vector. So we are not interested in working on zero vectors, right? So whenever, generally, whenever you talk about vectors, they are having certain magnitude, which is non-zero, remember. So always we will say, if a bar and b bar are collinear vectors, then any of them, it is not necessarily a bar, b bar also, can be expressed as a scalar multiple of other vector. That means, in short, A bar will be M into B bar, where what is M? M is non-zero scalar. So when you say A bar is M into B bar, also you can note that B bar is 1 upon M into A bar, and 1 upon M definitely exists because M is non-zero. You can divide by anything that is not zero. It means what? Whenever two vectors, in short, as a nutshell we can say, two vectors A bar and B bar are collinear if and only if any of those two vectors can be expressed as scalar multiple of other vector. This property will be very useful. Now, when you add two vectors, you have certain properties. That means what? The addition of the vectors is what we can say, it is a commutative. That means what? If you have two vectors A bar and B bar, then their addition, that is A bar plus B bar, is same as B bar plus A bar. That is what is known as the vector addition is commutative. Then vector addition is associative also. What do you mean by this? If A bar, B bar and C bar are any three vectors, then in bracket A bar plus B bar outside bracket plus C bar is equal to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. That is, addition of the three vectors is associative. That means grouping. If you group A bar and B bar together and write in bracket A bar plus B bar, now this is again a vector. Addition of two vectors is a vector. So when you add C bar in that, whatever vector you get is same vector that you are getting whenever you take A bar plus in bracket B bar plus C bar. Right? Like real numbers. In real numbers also you know addition is associative. Same property for the vector addition also. So what we can now conclude? Vector addition is commutative. A bar plus B bar is same as B bar plus A bar. Vector addition is associative. That means A bar plus B bar inside the bracket plus C bar is same as A bar plus inside the bracket B bar plus C bar. Right? So vector addition is commutative also, associative also. Now, for any vector A bar, if you add 0 vector in that, that means A bar plus 0 bar, or you take 0 bar plus A bar, it is A bar. So what we can say, 0 bar is called additive identity for the vector addition. In case of real numbers also, you know, 5 plus 0 is 5. So what is 0 called? Additive identity in case of real numbers. Similarly, in case of set of vectors, 0 bar is additive identity. That means when you add 0 bar to any vector, say A bar, the addition of these two vectors is again A bar. Okay, then what is additive inverse? You know, in real numbers, you know, 5, when you add minus 5 to that, you get 0. That means additive identity. Similarly, in case of vectors, if you take a vector A bar and to that vector, when you add minus A bar, it becomes 0 bar. Right? It becomes 0 bar. Now, there is something called polygonal law of vectors. Right? The addition of the vectors can be extended for any number of vectors. So let A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar be the vectors represented by say OA bar, AB bar, then BC bar, then CD bar. Okay, then triangle law of addition you can repeatedly use, right? And OB bar can be written as OA bar plus AB bar. So it will be A bar plus B bar. Then OC bar we can write as OB bar plus BC bar. So it will be OA bar plus AB bar plus BC bar. So it will be A bar plus B bar plus C bar. That means you can extend this. This is very simple. When you draw the figures, you can easily understand polygonal law of vectors. And finally, today we will discuss what is linear combination of the vectors. Linear combination. So if you have, say, n vectors, a1 bar, a2 bar, a3 bar, and so on up to an bar, and if alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, alpha n are n scalars, right, then what you do is consider alpha 1 a1 bar. This is a scalar multiple of the vector. You are multiplying vector a1 bar by alpha 1. Then a2 bar you multiply by alpha 2. a3 bar you multiply by alpha 3. Take a scalar multiplication. An bar by alpha n. So new vector that is formed by addition of all such vectors. Alpha 1 a1 bar plus alpha 2 a2 bar plus alpha 3 a3 bar, etc. up to alpha n an bar. This newly formed vector is called linear combination of the vectors a1 bar, a2 bar up to an bar. So in short, if you have a vector, say vectors, say a bar, b bar and c bar, three vectors, what you do is calculate, say 3a bar plus 2b bar plus 5c bar. This will be also a vector. And this vector is called linear combination of the vectors a bar, b bar and c bar. So these ideas, linear combination, then addition of the two vectors, then scalar multiplication of the vector, etc., are very useful for us in the further study of topic called vectors. I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.